Hi guys, welcome to Learning Online with Prep Class. I am Tutor Chima. Now you are welcome back to today's section. You will see in your screen, you'll be seeing our JAMB Biology 2015. That tells you that we are going to be looking at past questions on JAMB Biology for the year 2015. It is not the first time we are doing a video like this. Go through our channel, you will see lots of educational content we've had on JAMB Biology, Chemistry, Physics, and many other subjects. So today we are going to be looking at our questions number 36 to 40. Yes, because in the previous section we looked at questions 31 to 35. So today we are going to be looking at questions 36 to 40 of JAMB Biology 2015. Guys, before we proceed with this, do not forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, like our videos. You look below there, you see a notification bell. Click that notification bell and activate it so that once you do so, you'll be the first to be notified whenever we have an educational content like this on our channel. Feel free to use the share button to share our videos, like, comment. Okay. Now, you know all the traditions you do when you watch online stuff. So just do them, the positive ones. Do the positive ones. Alright guys, now let us proceed. Now, in the previous video, if you've not seen it, please advise you go back to our channel and watch the previous video. We are told to use this diagram to answer questions 35 and 36. So we've answered 35, so now this is number 36. The structure level I is the, this one, is the structure level I. Is it a zygospore? Is it a conidiospore? Is it a sporangium? Is it a hypha? Now, we learned in that our previous class that this diagram indicates sexual reproduction in rhizopods. So, in sexual reproduction in rhizopods, a dark zygospore is produced at the points where two compatible mycelia fuses. These two are mycelia. They fuse to form a zygospore. So, this, okay, this is the gametangia. Together, it's now developed into zygospore. This is a part level one, sorry. Now develop into a zygospore. So the name of this, the part label one, which is this, is the zygospore. So the correct answer is zygospore, option A. 37. We'll be giving an instruction. We say use the diagram to answer questions 37 and 38. Use the diagram to answer questions 37 and 38. What is this diagram? I believe this diagram is diagram of paramecium. This is a protozoa. Called paramecium. So the organelle responsible for asexual reproduction is it a part level 1, is it a part level 2, is it a part level 3, or the part level 4? A, is it IV, is it B, is it I, C, is it II, D, is it III? Okay, what of this organelle is responsible for asexual reproduction? Now, you must know that the part responsible for reproduction in a living organism is the nucleus, and a paramecium has two nuclei, nucleus singular, nuclei plural. A paramecium has two nuclei. This big one, which is a part level 2, is the meganucleus. This small one here, which is a part level 3, is the micronucleus. So a paramecium cell consists of two nuclei, micronucleus, which is a small one, and macronucleus, which is a large one. The smaller nucleus, which is the part level 3, which is this one, that's the micronucleus, is responsible for reproduction. In other words, it serves as the signaling organelle for asexual reproduction in paramecium. So this small nucleus, which is the micronucleus, is responsible for asexual reproduction in paramecium, that's cell division. The big nucleus is responsible for controlling all the cellular activities, control all the other cellular organelles. So the part level 3, which is the micronucleus, is responsible for asexual reproduction in paramecium, which is, so the correct answer to number 37 is option D, III, part level 3. 38. The part level 4 is responsible for, what's the part level 4? The part level 4 is the posterior. There are two contractile vacuoles. Okay, this is the anterior, this is the head, this is the tail. The part, this one that is not labeled, is the anterior contractile vacuole. This part level 4 is the second one, which is a posterior contractile faculty. So the part level 4 is responsible for, is it respiration, is it ingestion, is it locomotion, is it osmoregulation? Now you must know the function of the contractile faculty. The part level 4 is the posterior contractile faculty. Like I said before, contractile faculty is used for osmoregulation. That is the process by which an organism balances the level of water and salt or solutes in its cell. So is this contractile faculty that prevents, you know, because this paramecium, you know, as a cellular organism, water will continue permeating itself by osmosis. There's a tendency that water entering this cell has a tendency of causing this cell to swell and burst. But because the cell has a contractile faculty, which is two cells, one here and the other one here, this contractile faculty helps to eliminate excess water that enters that cell. And that process of regulating the amount of water that enters the cell is known as osmoregulation. So the part level 4, which is the posterior contractile faculty, is responsible for osmoregulation. So correct answer is osmoregulation. I believe you understand this, right? All right, let's fire on. Now, use the diagram to answer questions 39 and 40. Use the diagram to answer questions 39 and 40. 39 says, the part level 1 is the, first of all, what is this diagram? I believe you should know that this is the diagram of the mammalian heart. Mammalian heart. So the part level 1 is the, is it a pulmonary artery? Is it a bicuspid valve? Is it the aorta? Is it a vena cava? Now, look at the labeling. The part level 1, this one, is the big artery, which is the aorta. You can see it branches, telling you that it will send blood to many areas, all the parts of the body, except towards the lung. So the part level 1 is the aorta, the largest artery in the circulatory system. The part level 2, this one, located in the right part of the heart, which is the bicuspid valve. Then the part level 3, this one, is the right ventricle. And the part level 4 is the left ventricle. So the part level 1 is the aorta. So the correct answer is aorta. Aorta is the part level 1. So the correct answer is option C, aorta. Okay. 40. Oxygenated blood is pumped to the entire body from the part level A. Is it 4? Is it 1? Is it 2? Is it 3? Now, oxygenated blood is pumped from the left ventricle, and this is the left ventricle. You can see that it is thicker than the right ventricle. It's thicker, the walls of the left ventricle is thicker than the walls of the right ventricle. Why? Because it needs to pump blood all over the body, head, legs, everywhere in the body, with the exception of the lungs. So because of that, the walls of the left ventricle is what? Thicker. And the left ventricle is connected to the what? Aorta. So the left ventricle pumps oxygenated blood, blood that contains oxygen, to all the other parts of the body with the exception of lungs. And that type of circulation is called systemic circulation. So oxygenated blood is pumped from the left ventricle to the entire body via the aorta. So the left ventricle is the part level 4. So the part level 4 is the left ventricle. I believe you understand this, right? Okay. So the correct answer is A, the part level 4 is the left ventricle. So guys, we've come to the end of today's section of learning online with prep class. We'll look at JAMB Biology 2015. We'll solve question 36 to 40. I believe you enjoyed this section. I believe it was educative and entertaining. I believe you learned one or two things. At least you learned that the paramecium has two nuclei, a small one, micronuclei, responsible for reproduction, asexual reproduction, a large one, meganucleus, responsible for controlling all cell activities. Alright, so if you look here, you'll notice that we've dropped a link for you here, bit.ly/prepclasswhatsapp. Want to copy or type this link on your browser and load it. Once you do so, you'll be the first to be notified whenever we have an educational content like this on our channel. I hope you see the next video. Okay, bye. And do take good care of yourself.